pretty uneventful start to this video, but you know what? I'm gonna roll with it because this is how life is. Sometimes, you know, things don't start off great and they end up killer. And sometimes they start off really slow and they just get slower. You have to keep watching, and it's the only way to find out what happens. And right now you're finding out that it has not sped up at all, unfortunately. But guess what? It's gonna get exciting really soon, because I'm gonna tell you about a song that I've been asked a lot about throughout the years. It's off our Feel the Steel record. How many people have Feel the Steel? Almost everybody in the room has downloaded it for free, illegally. And there's a song on there called Girl from Oklahoma. That's why I have this acoustical guitar. You can see this is one of the most expensive guitars money can buy. It's a Gibson something or other. Really good guitar. And I rented it just for this. And this song on our Feel the Steel record is called Girl from Oklahoma. And a lot of people want to learn how to play it. As a matter of fact, it's been a huge influence on a lot of other rock bands, like Extreme. You know, Betancourt kind of ripped this song off, and then they did a song with it and it had a runaway hit, and still to this day has never offered me any money for that, which sucks. But, you know, I do see Nuno around town in the big cities like Los Angeles, Nashville, Boise, and whenever I see him, I always mention that to him. So he buys me sandwiches and things like that. Anyway, I'm losing track. What I want to talk to you about is how to play it. I'm going to show you how to play it right now. It's really, really fun. I'll show you the rhythm part on my rented guitar. Check it out. So this is really, really, really easy. So if you can't do this on your first try, you might want to think about taking up another instrument. I'm just kidding. It's really difficult. It just looks easy because I'm doing it really well. But very simple chords. You got your G5, I guess that would be considered. You know, there's no third in there. So you got G, D, G, D, G, right? That's what you're starting with. You got your thumb down here. That's your driving your bass note right there. Uh-huh. And you got your rhythm guitar hand up here. These three little fingers. Uh-huh. So you got... And see, every time after every single one, I make sure that I slam my hand down on those strings. That's your snare drum. Because you know what? Everybody hates drummers. I know you hate drummers as much as I do. Why even have a drummer on the song? You don't need a drummer. They're just gonna show off and then try to screw all the girls after the show. So you get rid of the drummer and you use that part of your hand to be the drummer. So I'm moving the bass note around, right? I do that better than the bass player. Bass players are dumb, everybody knows that. Go up to the C note there. So, notice how the rhythm changed just slightly. But really, I think one of the hardest things for most people to do, it's kind of like the walking and chewing gum thing. That's very difficult for me. I'm still working on that. That's why I'm not chewing gum right now. But is just making that backbeat on the 2 and the 4. Because it's easy to mess that up. Ow. So there we go. That's practice it slowly. And Maybe not that slow. That's like just really annoying. But don't go too fast, because then you'll be like. And that doesn't sound sexy. So you want to find that super sexy right in the middle. And you'll know, because when you get it right, that cute little neighbor girl that lives down the hall, she'll be knocking on your door. Excuse me, Ron. I just was wondering if maybe I could use your hairdryer. And you'll be like, hold on, I'm practicing the guitar. I'm just kidding, Ron, I wanna have sex. All right, you know what I'm saying? That's how it works. 2, 3, 4. So this is the chorus. This chorus is not too hard. Doesn't move around as much as the verses. Pretty simple. It's basically a 1-4-5. It's basically a blues, guys, right? You know the blues, right? You guys grew up in south of the Delta, whatever the hell, you know. It's blues, dude. You should know this. It's a 1-4-5. It's basically C to G, C to D. It's Louie Louie. A Louie Louie. It's the same thing. I just ripped off Louie Louie. Actually, and then Nuno Betancourt stole it from me. Okay? Yes, Nuno. Still waiting for the royalties on that one. So anyway, you got. Those top three notes stay in the same spot almost the same time, almost the whole time. It changes when it goes to D. And then this part, open G string the whole time with a C and E and then D and F sharp. And then, so you got easy little shape, you move up the neck, and then that's it. Pretty much the whole chorus right there. And let me tell you something, one of the best choruses I ever wrote that was stolen. Okay, so the bridge part. I like this bridge part because it's got a lot of chords and it shows off how many chords I know. And that is really intimidating to a lot of girls if they think that you know a lot of stuff. And the more chords you can show them in one bridge section, it ups your chances of actually getting girls after the show. Because especially the girls with low self-esteem, they will be like, oh my God, I'm never gonna know that many chords. The best I can hope for is to have sex with Satchel. So anyway, you got a G7, right? C major, which is super easy. All the girls will see that and go, oh, that's just C major. But then it goes to C minor. C minor after C major, what? And then to B minor. How would you go from C minor to B minor and not sound weird? Normally, that's just weird. I know. So girls are going, this guy is a freak. He made those two chords sound good together. So you got G7, C major, C minor, hits him from out of the blue into B minor, I'm freaking out. E major, nobody would have done that. Is this guy like Dylan or something? A minor, D to D, which is total standard, like jazz 2-5-1 kind of stuff. Right, because it's like 2-5-1, back to G. I know my chords, dog, But guess what? This is not jazz, all right? And you can tell it's not jazz because I have long hair and there's girls at my shows. So that's it. That's pretty much the whole progression right there. I'm gonna play it one more time. So the solo part is pretty simple, except for there's a couple parts that are not easy, especially if you're drunk like I am right now. I'm pretty drunk. Because here at Guitar World, there's a guy named Andy Elidor, and he gives me alcohol to come in.
Can I top that off for you?
Yeah. Well, I didn't even know that. Where did it go? We were doing shots earlier, but anyway, so the solo starts like this. Pretty easy right there. Pretty simple melodic stuff. In the key of G major. There's a little string skip right there. And some pull-offs. And then we got a big pull-off right here on the G and D strings. Which always sounds good on acoustics. When you do that kind of stuff. Because it's easy and girls think that you're better than you are. So that's really the whole goal here, is to put minimum amount of effort into sounding awesome. So you got, then you got the like probably the hardest part of the solo, which is, it's not easy to do slow. So you got hammering on the first three notes. And picking the next three. So it's not an easy lick to do, and it's good to play that with a metronome, because otherwise you can just go like that. So that's probably a Paul Gilbert-ish type of exercise that a lot of people can practice doing their triplets. And just get quicker until you feel comfortable with it. And the next part, just down G pentatonic. I think that's what I did on the record. I can't remember. It was so long ago, and I was pretty drunk at that time, too. But most of it's G major, this whole solo, and it's really just a matter of practicing and doing it slow on an acoustic guitar, because when you're playing the acoustic guitar, you don't have any distortion to cover up all your bad notes. And so that means you have to be way more precise than you would be if you were at a show and you were drunk with a distortion pedal. So that's where the practice comes in, guys. But it is a fun song and solo to play, and it will get you more girls than the Slayer song that you learned last week.